Okay, here we are on part two of the Hollywood Child Protection Act Ignored and Why It's Important. I'm going to put the link to the article below so you can read it for yourself if you want to. Wide support, little follow-through. The bill has made wide support has been backed by the MPAA and the Association of Talent Agents, SAG, and the AFTRA pre-merger are both behind it, too. And so are the Talent Managers Associations in Los Angeles, Attorney's Office, among with all these other groups that are... The only opposition that comes from it, ironically, is the sex offenders laws, which lobbies to protect convicted sex offenders. Okay, so they're against it, of course. We were very supportive of the legislations, is Duncan Crabtree, Ireland, SAG, AFRT, CEO, and General Counsel. And we remain insistent that it's necessary. It is clear this applies to photographers, managers, coaches, and publicists. And we like to see that all these professionals who work with children are registered, but that's required by law. We are going to reach out to these people to make sure that they understand what's going on pretty much and that they, they have an obligation to register. I'm just kind of sub-quoting that. Yeah, it's been 5 years. I'm pretty sure they got the memo and they need to start enforcing this law. It is distressing, he said. So many industry professionals have failed to register. The point of having this law in the first place was to ensure the industry who works regularly with children would be subject to background checks, and that's exactly what they need to do. You've seen, like, these people coming in working with child already convicted of sex offenders. It's disgusting. Hollywood publicists, however, haven't gotten the message. A database maintained by the Department of Industrial Relations lists 292 valid permit holders who are regularly allowed to work with children. It indicates the guidelines to parents, but the deadline review of every permit holder reveals not a single publicist holds a child performer permit, a service permit, which is crazy. I mean, you got the memo. They need to have it, and you'll hear some of the shows that don't have it. It's crazy. Deadline has found that 20 Los Angeles-based publicists who don't have the permits but represent child stars on numerous TV shows, including Stranger Things, This Is Us, Modern Family, Blackish, Lost in Space, Revenge, Code Black. Publicists without permits also represent young stars on Nickelodeon, School of Rock, Henry Danger, Nikki, Ricky, Dicky, and Dawn, and on the Disney Channel, Stuck in the Middle and Raven's Home. They often represent child actors in numerous films, including The Fence and the upcoming Bumblebee, just to name a few. And that's crazy. Any manager, publicist, or photographer, or acting coach who provides services to minors are responsible for complying with the law, which requires them to have a permit, says Paula Laverine, Public Information Officer for the Department of Industrial Relations, which enforces the law. If the Labor Commissioner finds out a violation or is alerted of a business working with minors in violation of the permit requirements, it will pass those names along to appropriate prosecuting agencies. Okay, so we just listed TV shows that have, in places that have people not registered. Let's pass those names on. Let's start enforcing this. This is absolutely crazy. This is why the kids in Hollywood keep getting abused. Along with the professionals specifically addressed by the law are public relations services or publicists, or both, including arranging personal appearances, developing, distributing packages, managing fan mail, designing, and maintaining internet websites. And they're required because... to get the permit because they're working with anybody under the age of 18. The law is more widely adhered to among personal managers, in part because the Talent Managers Association has been telling its members about it for years, strongly encouraging members who represent children actors to obtain the permit. Our members are definitely aware of the law, said TMA President Verza Murana. Sorry if I said that. We sent emails to our members telling them, and any manager who works with children must have a permit. We make very clear that we were to make sure that the parents know that their children's managers are safe and have been cleared by the state. There is nothing more important than the safety of our children, which is absolutely true. Manos, who represents the two child actors, has a permit, as do the TMA Vice President Nikki Minix and Corresponding Secretary Betty McCormick. We highly recommend that members who represent children have the performing service permits. Amen. So do I, and I think a lot of other people. It will prevent pedophiles from getting in, or at least help try to prevent. More than 40 managers are listed in the state's database of permit holders, but deadlines have found an equal number who don't have permits but manage the careers of child performers anyway. These managers of young stars on many shows that are mentioned, as well as the other ones including Jane the Virgin, Shameless, and designated survivors of such spells like Wrinkle in Time, The Guardian, Galaxy Volume 2, The Book of Henry, and the upcoming Chapter 2. I'm a little mad about seeing... in other words, publicists and managers all over town are guiding the camera of young performers who they legally are not allowed to represent. The law does not apply to the talent agents who are covered by a different law requiring that they, head of the agencies, be fingerprinted. It's also applied that studio teachers who also have been fingerprinted and passed background checks. Casting managers, producers, actors, directors aren't required to permits either, although many do, mostly to coach, teach young performers. I thought it was weird because there's a couple shows on there that I watched and I thought was pretty questionable, and then find out they're not, you know, following the law. It's really disgusting. Jane's, I'm sorry if I mispronounce this, whatever, has a permit to manage minors and said that a lack of awareness about the laws is mostly the reason for many managers of the child actors not to have permits. I don't know if people are aware of it. I think it's educating managers about this is required, which... Yeah, that's true, but from the interview, it's very clear publicists don't even know about the law, while other mistakenly think that it doesn't apply to them. We took a look at a lot of agent managers who work with kids, and I have never heard of this and never been doing that. I've been doing this for 20 years, an LA-based publicist who represents several child stars. I work with 50 to 100 people every day, and I don't think of them ever heard of it either. I've seen it seems weird that publicists would even have to... need this. Not necessarily, I disagree. I think anybody who comes in contact with children, especially in this time, should have some kind of background check to ensure that they're not already a registered pedo like some of these other people that's been in Hollywood. After reading the law, she called back to say that it does not apply to her because any of the exceptions spelled out in the law, which states that it doesn't apply to a person whose contact with a minor is restricted to a location either by the law or regulations. The minor must be accompanied at all times by a parent, guardian, and a parent or guardian, and must be within sight of the minor. The law said, she said, doesn't apply to her because I've never alone with the child clients. They're always with their parents. Okay, I guess that, you know, but I don't know. I think everybody should comply, and if they're not, you should just start turning their names over. I don't understand. And there's been proof that some of these people know. They already said that they know. I don't know. Just to put down your comments below how you feel. I have a part 3 coming up. All right, bye-bye.